Hi, everybody. My name is Doug Goldstein. I am the creator of the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal. First of all, let me just say, I really am grateful that you are here. I'm assuming that the reason that you are here is because either you picked up a copy of the Gratitude Journal, or maybe someone gave it to you as a present, and you opened it up and you found out that instead of reading all of the material in the beginning, which I do recommend you read, you could just go to a brief video that explains what the book is all about and how to use it. So this is the quick start video for the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal. There are a few things I want to just explain to you in this video, but for starters, I want to explain to you where it came from. What's the idea of constant happiness? As I'm sure you may know, sometimes you feel down, sometimes you feel other people are down, sometimes people can feel down for a long, long time. In my day job, as I like to refer to it, I'm a financial advisor, so I work with some people who are filled with money and some people who don't quite have as much money. But I have to tell you, and there are plenty of academic studies which back this up, people who have more and more and more money are no happier than people who have moderate sums of money or even not so much money. Happiness is not about having more and more stuff. Happiness really is about appreciating all of the things that you have. So using the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal is a way to actually make you feel happier all the time. And the fundamental idea behind it is that if you can have appreciation for all of the things around you, then you'll just be a happier person. So where does this come from? Number one, we're going to talk about today that gratitude is what leads to happiness. Number two is I'm going to explain to you literally the one thing that you need to know in order to get yourself into a positive attitude where you have a lot of gratitude, having, as we say, the attitude of gratitude. And number three is I'm going to explain to you what is this all about, this stream of consciousness idea, which is really the model of the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal. Okay, so number one, what's the main idea? What's the idea that gratitude is what leads to happiness? Let's look at it from the opposite side. Let's talk about a person who simply doesn't have gratitude. I'm sure you know people like this in your life, and maybe sometimes even you feel this way. You just don't appreciate the things around you. A lot of times we can identify that with kids or younger people. I shouldn't knock them because quite frankly, a lot of them really do have a lot of gratitude, but someone who gets a present and doesn't appreciate it. And really, what might that present be? So that present could be, wow, I woke up this morning. That's a huge gift. Didn't have to happen that way. Lots and lots of people didn't wake up this morning. So why not take a moment and really appreciate it? And then once you appreciate what you have, you'll be happier. The more happy things you can do, the better. Again, look at the opposite. Look at a student who goes to school. He doesn't appreciate his teachers. He doesn't appreciate the homework. He doesn't appreciate the education. You can be sure this is not going to be a happy student. Or you have, let's say, a spouse. Maybe there's a woman who doesn't appreciate the things that her husband does for her. Is she going to be happy in that marriage? No, the answer is. So what we need to do is we need to figure out how we can be happy on a regular basis. The idea, of course, of the Gratitude Journal, which we'll talk about in a minute, is to think about the things that are good going on in your life and to write them down. But the problem is sometimes if someone just asks you a broad question like, well, what are you happy about? Tell me why this year is better than last year. It's such a big question that it's really hard to narrow down into the specifics. And what are those specifics? Well, those specifics are always going to be determined or easily isolated, easily identified by using one of your five senses. Your five senses are hearing, seeing, touching, smelling, and tasting. So when you're ready to start thinking about what you're happy about, stop and just choose any one of those five senses. Let's say you choose the sense of tasting. Okay, I'm just thinking now about the lunch I had before, which in my case actually was peanut butter and jelly. Even at my age, I still happen to like it a lot. My age is, by the way, I'm already a grandfather, for which I am eternally grateful. But I appreciated that sandwich. I liked the way the bread was squishy. I liked the flavor of the jelly. It was a plum jelly, which was amazing. I liked the peanut butter. I'm beginning to think about that taste. Now when I think about actually buying the bread, I remember when I was at the store, the guy at the store said to me, wait, don't get that one, get this one. And he recommended like a whole wheat bread that was a little bit healthier. And I have to tell you, I really liked the flavor. So what I'm doing now is, by the way, I'm leading into the third and final thing I wanted to talk to you about, which is this concept of stream of consciousness. Once you get involved in the gratitude stream of consciousness, one thing just leads to the next, right? The guy in the store who recommended that I buy this bread instead of that bread. And then I went to the cash register and I pulled out my credit card and I was able to pay without any problem. The transaction just went right through. Money went from my bank to pay this guy for the food that came from, well, actually the bread came from dozens of miles away, I think, where it was manufactured. It was brought by a truck. And some guy who drove that truck, and this is his job every day, he makes sure that I always have fresh bread. Can you see where I'm going with this? Once you start thinking of one thing, you can get to the next thing and write them all down. Now, you do not need to write in the gratitude journal a huge paragraph, a huge essay. This is not you applying to college to try and get in and explain your whole philosophy of gratitude. This is you taking a quick note. If you see a bird over there and you think it's pretty, pretty bird, right? That's all you need to write. The idea is to get you writing. It's not to win some award for being the world's greatest writer. And that is really all that the gratitude journal is about. If you want constant happiness, you need to appreciate things around you constantly. Try it yourself. Get a copy for someone else you know. If, by the way, you don't actually like writing by hand, it's not a problem to use an app. There are plenty of apps that you can use on your phone, whether it's Evernote or Drafts or OneNote or Simple Note or just simply a Word document that you save in Dropbox. The technology doesn't matter. In fact, in the beginning of the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal, I list a number of apps that a lot of people like to use for this. So the idea is not the writing, what you write or how you write it. It's just simply getting something down on paper that makes you happy, that you appreciate. And that is what constant happiness is all about. I would really love to hear how it works for you. Please be in touch at our website. Once again, my name is Doug Goldstein. I'm the creator of the Constant Happiness Gratitude Journal. Welcome to the world of constant happiness.